So where are we now?
We're in Asana. And this list over here is everything that I wanted to cover in this course.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, so arrays in JavaScript are just like lists. In this case, the zeroth item is intro, after that we have GitHub, and so on.
I'm really glad you said zeroth, because JavaScript arrays are zero index.
Yeah, they sure are. Let's take a look.
Arrays are just lists of values, and they behave the same as lists in Python. We start lists with the same syntax as before, with var, and then the name of the array, followed by an equal sign. The array will be defined by these square brackets, with items inside separated by commas. Let's make an array of skills. This could be really useful in our resumes later. So I'll go ahead and start with var skills, and then I'll start with awesomeness.
That's not a skill, dude.
It actually is if you check my LinkedIn profile. Then I've got programming, teaching, and JavaScript, all separated by commas. I'll go ahead and append the skills to the page, save it, come over here, hit refresh, and we can see it on the page. It's not separated by any commas or spaces here because we didn't have any commas or spaces within the strings in our skills array. And we can see that we have now just awesomeness added to the end of our array. Let's say I just wanted to append the first item, awesomeness, to the page instead. I'll start by commenting out this line, and then using bracket notation, I'll append the zeroth item of the skills array to the main div on the page. I'll go ahead and save this, come over to the browser and hit refresh, and we can see that we just have awesomeness on the page now because we use bracket notation.
Nice. One cool thing is that JavaScript gives us a way of accessing properties about the array. In fact, you should give it a try. Let's take a quiz.